Hello, and welcome to an Introduction to Asset Manager. This short video is designed to give you a quick introduction to Asset Manager so you can see what this easy-to-use software can do for you and your business. Asset Manager is a Windows software application with a powerful database for managing the assets in your organization. With Asset Manager, you can manage an unlimited number of asset records, attach pictures, owner's manuals, and other files, print your own barcodes or use existing barcodes, use a barcode scanner to check items in or out to employees, perform an audit of your assets, track related vendors and contacts, print, save, and email reports. Okay, now let's take a look at Asset Manager. You may navigate to the main sections of Asset Manager using the tabs along the top of the window. Here you will see the Asset List View, Personnel, Vendors, and Reports. Assets are categorized in folders on the left, and you may create new asset type folders as needed. The list view displays the assets in the database, and you may filter the list by selecting an asset type folder or by using the quick search box. To select different columns to display in the list, right-click on the grid and select the menu item, Show Columns. Double-click on an asset row to open the asset form, which contains all the details. There are data fields in the top part of the form and tabs along the bottom, with additional fields for general information as well as Finance, Service, Notes, Attachments, and History. You can click the blue help icon at any time for more information about that screen. For example, to find more information about the loan agreements field on the asset form, click the help icon and locate the loan agreement section for more information about that feature. You can open an asset record by locating it in the asset list and double-clicking it, or by scanning the barcode on the item. To check the asset out to an employee, click the checkout button or press the F3 key on your keyboard. You may then scan the employee's badge or select their name from the list. Scan additional asset barcodes if needed, add comments, and then complete the checkout. You can find more information about this feature in the user guide. Okay, next, let's take a look at the personnel section. Personnel records are organized in group folders, and you may create new groups to match your organization's structure. You can filter personnel by group or use the quick search box to find a record. You can also scan an employee badge to open the related record. The personnel form contains several data fields as well as tabs along the bottom for Assets Checked Out, Attachments, Notes, and History. You can check in multiple items all at once by selecting the rows while holding down the Shift or Control key and then clicking the Check In button. Adjust any of the information as needed and then click the Complete Check In button. The Vendors tab works in much the same way, with buttons along the top to add, edit, and delete records, a quick search box, and more. The vendor form contains all of the details including the related assets, file attachments, and notes. On the Report tab, you can select a report from the list of reports on the left and then set data options for grouping, sorting, and filtering. Use the Options button to add your company name and logo. And for even more options, open the report in a new window and you can choose from the menu or toolbar along the top to print the report, export the report, send it by email, and more. Okay, we just completed a quick tour through the main areas of the user interface. Finally, let's take a brief look at the menu options available along the top of the main window. From the File menu, you can create new records, backup a database, restore a database, or exit the program. The View menu allows you to change the color style. The Tools menu includes features to search the database, send an overdue checkout reminder, manage selection field values, import data, export data, set the database connection in the Enterprise Edition, set database security, and configure settings for your barcode reader. You can find more information about all of these features in the user guide by clicking the Help icon on the related screen or by selecting the menu option Help, Contents. Thanks for watching this quick introduction to Asset Manager. For more information, please visit our website at www.kzsoftware.com and install the free trial version available on the download page.